we are going to have one pilot ladder session for them as well as the Samyukta competition, this thing. So anyway, we quickly start. I need to explain to you as to what competition is. Hi. Okay. So good afternoon, sir. Thank you very much for this opportunity to explain to Amit, since you're a vice principal of Nautical Studies College. I would also like to have engineering principal roped in next time, because it is very important that this unique competition is explained. You know, that is why I want to really touch base with all the MTIs and explain them, because just sending your email and sending a flyer and brochure won't help, I think, because the subject is very unique. You know, this competition is arranged by AMPA and IMU. So IMU is our kind of a vehicle where we have launched this thing, because IMU has also, you know, Madam Malini Shankar has shown great interest in this. And of course, it is an innovation competition. And being for the first time in India, a research paper competition, or that too on pilot ladder. So we have a double whammy, which is good for maritime industry, because this is the first time the our you know, the graduate, undergraduate college students will showcase some research potential to the world. You know, we've been doing a lot of technical paper competitions, no doubt about it. But research paper is, this is the first one. And again, on pilot ladder, innovation is something which is a very unique subject. The competition is being held online, number one.
Okay.
And number two, that the competition's name is Samyukta. I mean, it is a Sanskrit name. Like Samyukta means closing to something. So in this case, the pilot ladder, we are closing in with the risk management. You know, the pilot ladder is a very old concept. I mean, it's about 300 years old now. And we've been still using it. Some regulations have come new, some ISO standards have come, you know, some IMO resolutions have come for making it a better place, better you know, kind of equipment for the transform. But still, we have the risk of losing life on pilot ladder, and there are about 2 to 3 lives lost every year.
No wonder, 2 minutes of the meeting. Like, yes, sir,
we have about 2 to 3 lives, 2 to 3 lives lost every year, and this is a very high time now that we must find an alternative to pilot ladder, or we change the, you know, the root causes of accidents. Now, mainly the root causes of the accidents have been the damage to the pilot ladder, because of the non-proper securing, non-proper, you know, rigging of the pilot ladder, no upkeep and care and maintenance. You know, all these are with the root causes. And the same pilot ladder, when it is used number of times, one fine day it breaks and somebody loses his life. So, AMPA decided to, you know, agitate this issue in the industry. We have done that at many levels, including MDI trainings, you know, shipping company joining crew trainings, and taking it to administration. Now, the fact of the matter is that the administration now has agreed to issue a MS notice onto the pilot ladder inspection. And they also have agreed earlier to do a focus inspection on all vessels calling Indian ports. So that's going to be a very good thing for us on safety of the, you know, on the pilot ladder. But we also thought that why don't we flare the young minds? Because today, if we get more the MTI students involved, the cadets involved, these cadets are going to be in the industry for next 20 years. And this next 20 years, they will remember something about pilot ladder they learned. They took part in competition and they did some, you know, research on this. So that's going to be further enhancing the safety. This is another percolation of AMPA. Third important point is, you know, that what AMPA is trying to project to everyone is that the pilot ladder is basically a workplace safety hazard. And it has got an international recognition into the SOLAS regulation, but SOLAS belongs to the ship, and the pilot transfer procedure, which belongs to the port. You know, like how the cargo oil tanker, which comes inside the port, the capability of transferring the oil cargo and the safeties are ensured by the port, not by the cargo officer or the cargo manager or the terminal manager. You know, it has been ensured by the port at the ship which is coming in, can effectively transfer cargo without any pollution, without any explosion or a fire and hazard risk. So similarly, because they own the oil transfer procedure. Similarly, the pilot transfer procedure is owned by the port. So we want port to take active interest in this and ensure that the pilot ladders are used, rigged, and can be used to effectively transfer the pilot or the personnel on board. So this is also an attempt towards the kind of a declaration by the maritime fraternity that the pilot ladder is a potential safety hazard, is a workplace safety hazard as well. And hence the workplace being a port or terminal, the port must take charge of it, not leave it to the vessel, because vessel never uses the pilot ladder. Pilot ladders are used by only by pilots and not by the ship's crew also at times. So that is also the issue. So we decided to have this competition. This competition is online. This competition calls for a research paper, abstract and research paper, about 3,000 words maximum. What is expected out of students is that any number of participants can take part from the MTI. They are supposed to do a research on the hazard identification, the methodology to reduce these hazards as to what the hazards are all about, and then come up with the innovative solution as to if they can think, because the young minds are very important today. I mean, they can really change the, they don't have a prejudiced mind like you and me, who have climbed the pilot ladder 1,000 times, but they have a completely different outlook altogether, and they will definitely think out of box as to why not do like this and why do like this. Somebody was telling me when I told him about the, Manila rope, and I was taking a class in one of the MTIs about pilot ladder. He said, "Sir, why do you use Manila rope? Why can't we use steel ropes? They will never break."
Steel
Yeah.
rope.
So I told him, but don't you think that they'll get spoiled by the weather?" He said, "Never mind, sir. I mean, we can change them after 2 years. At least it will be easily visible that the steel rope will be rusted, will become red." What I'm trying to say here is not that that solution is right or wrong, but he came up with a solution by application of his mind, and that is very
True.
important. By that, asking questions and giving solution, he might remember as to why the pilot ladders are made like that. And this competition will be judged by the international judges. We have about 9 judges so far confirmed, and they all are pilots in different parts of the world, including Australia, New Zealand, and even Tom Cockerill is there. It's who's a maritime safety pilot in United Kingdom, a very legendary figure. And all those guys who have been in part and have taken a very active part in the pilot ladder safety in the world, they are going to be the judges. And towards the end, what we are going to do is we're going to select 10 papers maximum, 10 best papers among all the MTIs, and those 10 papers students will have a kind of a presentation online in front of the esteemed crowd, where they can explain as to what the mitigation measures are with respect to the risk, and also they will explain the what are the solutions, out of box solutions they have, or if any alternative innovation to the pilot ladder can be brought in at that point in time. And I mean, recently we saw one Netherlands video of a gravity testing, so that is also one of the solutions on the card. There could be many more solutions like this, which the young minds can come today. And for that, we have a special prize of Industry 4.0 solution.
5 minutes, sir. 5 minutes, Yes,
For
sir,
that, we have a
please.
special prize of for Industry 4.0 solution of 5,000 rupees. So basically, I mean, to put it in a nutshell, I would like maximum number of participants to take part from AMET, as well as for AMET engineering students also can take part. This is open for the nautical science, DNS, BSc Nautical Science, DNS, and BE Marine Tech. There was a thought to see if the passed out students can take part also, who are waiting to join a ship. So I've said, okay, I will think about it and let you know. You will get the email invite from IMU shortly, because IMU headquarters will send the emails of invitation of papers.
I
And
received a mail from you yesterday. Shall I share that mail along with the attachment to all the groups? Yesterday you sent me a mail.
correct, correct. You can share that.
Is
Share that as well.
that
IMU also will send you a new mail
okay?
with the registration form, with the brochure, which can be shared with the students and which can be shared with the professors. I mean, what I would like to say is that you can, you know, ask some of the dedicated professors of your college to prepare teams. You know, if they require some help, professors require some help, we can offer them with the industry data and things like that. We will not talk to students as such because it will be a biased thing otherwise. So, okay. Up to 30th April, you will be given the mails and the brochure and the flyers and everything, rules and regulations, okay. Conditions and all that. Up to 15th of May, you have a time to declare the names of participants.
Okay.
Once you declare the names of participants, then they have a time till 30th of June, 45 days, to submit a 3,000-word research paper on pilot ladder.
Once they register, do they automatically become a participant or again the MTA should declare the participants?
No, no. Once MTA has to register for them, there is no registration fee. The MTA has to set a form. Yeah, there is no registration fee.
No, I mean to ask you, can the students register on their own? Can they register on their own? So the MTA should register.
No, MTA should register because he has to be a bona fide student. You know, he has to be a bona fide student. Our MTA has to put a principal has to put a stamp and signature on the registration form.
I see. Okay.
And once the you can give 5 teams, 10 teams, whatever teams are. I mean, whatever teams you desire. The team is of 3 people, 2 speakers, and 1 researcher. Is a team comprising of, and this team can you can have a number of teams of college. They have to give the papers before 30th of June, and from 30th June, then we will scrutinize the papers for the whole month with the different places all over the world and grade them, and then select 10 top papers and let you know by first week of July as to what are the you know by sorry first week of August we'll let you know the yeah. Timelines are there in the brochure. First week of August we'll let you know as to who are the first top 10 students, who are the students from your listing as well. So accordingly, okay. Then those students will get the chance to present the paper and demonstrate their thinking and skills online, you know, with the in front of the judges as well. So out of those last 10, we will select top 3 papers and they'll be given award. Everyone taking part will get a certificate of appreciation and participation. Okay. Top 10 will get a memento. And of course, the top 3 will get the cash prize as well. You know,
okay.
The prizes are being sponsored by HIMD. The first prize is of 12,000 rupees. Second prize is of 6,000 rupees. And the third prize is of 5,000 rupees, which is for a solution which is based on Industry 4.0 solution, you know, Industry 4.0 technology, AI or something like that. You know, I mean, if students can think of something very different, you know. So that's it. I mean, I would like, sir, definitely you, your enthusiasm is great in the all of the programs of AMPA. And I've seen that you're supporting AMPA very well in all our endeavors, with pilot ladder and everything. So I would like you to really push this to the students. Yeah. And nominate some 1-2 professors. I can anytime again talk to them if you want me to again have one more session explaining us what competition is all about. But you will receive the by end of this month you will receive the brochure and flyer and the welcoming mail, participation mail, okay. And it will be all clear to you.
Okay. So once I receive the set of registration details from you, then I'll share it in the WhatsApp group.
Correct.
That will be ideal. And then you mean to say I need to get the interested students and on behalf of them, the MTA has to register. Am I right,
correct.
Sir?
Correct, sir. Okay. Absolutely. You have 15 days for that. You have got 15, okay. Up to 15 from May, you can register.
Okay, right. Okay.
Yeah?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Any more questions? If you have, you can ask. Oh, I mean,
nothing at the moment. I find everything is a fantastic initiative. I would like to just keep my hats off for you.
No, sir. We have to showcase this to the world because idea of roping the international judges was that the people should know that our MTIs are doing well. Our MTIs have the research potential. This will also help us in placement. This will also help us in bringing the image of our MTIs up. So the efforts are very cumulative, you know. I mean, it's not only pilot ladder. It's about the entire education system in India, which is going to be for the first time research oriented. You know,
okay,
that's the idea. Yeah.
Very nice, sir. We definitely
thank
support.
You very much. Yeah. Thanks for your time. Thank you very much. Okay, sir. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thank you, Captain. Bye.
Thanks. Thanks, Farhan. Thank you. Thanks for your time.
Yeah.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you, Farhan. Yeah. Bye.
Thank you. Thanks.